sound you just heard? That's the all new DJI FPV drone. It screams. I've spent the last month flying it in Hawaii, and I'm gonna give you guys a look at all the amazing footage that I filmed with the DJI FPV drone, and also talk about where this is gonna end up in the DJI line. And basically, by the end of this video, you're going to want to go to dronenerds.com and buy this all new drone. So if you're not trying to buy a new drone today, you might wanna go ahead and just go watch another video, because if you keep watching, you're gonna wanna buy it. I'm promising you that. I'm promising you that. Let's do it. Go ahead and get it out of the way and let everyone know that this is the first time I've ever flown a FPV drone. I'm gonna say right now that the build quality on this thing is top notch. Really, the innovation that they've built with this, that you can see just the overall frame and the way it's built, it's very clean. I'd say it's sexy. If you look on the front here, something that's different from a lot of other FPV drones out there is it has obstacle avoidance on the front. It's also got sensors on the bottom. So you do not need to be a drone racing expert to fly this drone. You could basically never fly a drone your entire life, and this could be the first drone you've ever owned, and you would be totally fine, because this drone here, the FPV, flies basically in normal mode. It flies exactly like every other DJI drone. It's very, very, very easy to fly. And I wanna get that out there, make it clear, because I know people are gonna be like, oh, you know, I've never really flown FPV. I don't know if I can do it. Trust me. I've never flown FPV before I filmed with this drone. And well, here we are. And then it's got a gimbal. This is basically a one-axis gimbal, and that's gonna stop a little bit of the movement and shake. But overall, the actual drone is very smooth flying through the sky. I did have a little bit of resistance flying when it was really windy. But again, you know, without that three-axis gimbal, you're gonna have a little bit of that shake. And that's kind of part of the FPV experience. It's more raw, I guess is what you could say. You're flying in sport mode, the sensors can be turned off so they don't stop you. So if you're flying directly at a tree and all of a sudden you need to stop, you hit the brake button and the drone literally stops on a dime, which I think is another really cool feature, especially if you're not a pro. I like the battery. If you look at the battery here, it looks kind of similar to like a Inspire battery, a little bit smaller if you compare it to the Mavic battery. And it's kind of got that rugged feel too as well. So I think the batteries are gonna hold up. The battery actually kind of works with the body of the drone. Without the actual battery in the drone's very lightweight. So the battery obviously is gonna add, you know, a little bit of weight there. And it just pops in the back. So we've got the battery out of the way. We've talked about the gimbal. You've got a 4K camera that shoots 60 frames per second. It is gonna be a little bit, you know, more of a fisheye compared to some of the other drones like the Mavic Air 2. And that's where I think you have the Mavic Air 2 and you have like the FPV as like the ultimate combo to be able to combine the two. The Mavic Air 2 for, you know, the more cinematic, and then the FPV for like the more action in your face type shots. You've got a couple different modes as well. You've got the normal mode, which is basically just like flying a normal DJI drone right out of the box. It's really simple, really easy. Then you've got the sport mode, and then you've got the full manual mode, which is gonna be like flying a FPV racing drone. But the sport mode is gonna give you, you know, top speed. It's gonna be a lot more aggressive. The battery's not gonna last as long when you're just going full out all the time. So you gotta kind of think about that. You're gonna definitely wanna order multiple batteries, because you're gonna end up wanting to be in sport mode going full speed all of the time, because I'll tell you right now, there's no point in not being in sport mode when flying the FPV. So if you're gonna buy the FPV drone, definitely buy like 5 batteries, because I had 3 batteries and I had no problem burning through those batteries because I just kept wanting to fly and fly and fly. These are the DJI FPV goggles. We've seen these before. They're cool, they're futuristic. You kind of look funny when you're wearing them. The picture quality is amazing, I will say that. The quality, when you're looking through the goggles, the picture quality is insane. The feed, the transmission, the signal, everything is top notch. I have zero complaints, and I flew in a very kind of diverse area with mountains and forests and trees and all types of things to block signal, and I never had really any issues. I did lose connection one time when I flew underneath a bridge, and I lost connection. I actually thought I lost the drone. The drone was able to come back to me in return home mode, not run into the bridge. That's the one nice thing about having the obstacle avoidance, is the drone was actually able to rise up, turn around, and then come back to me, get signal again, and then I could fly it home. So the obstacle avoidance, I know people are gonna be like, well, I don't need obstacle avoidance because I'm the best pilot. And I get it, and that's totally fine. But the obstacle avoidance could save you in the end. You know, it could help you out in a tight squeeze if you, you know, need that return home feature. You can see here the new remote has like kind of this flip up antenna on it. It's got very like precise racing drone type controller here. The feedback is amazing. Like I said, this thing is like flying, I wouldn't say like a Ferrari, it's like flying a Lamborghini Aventador through the air. That's really what it comes down to. The controller is very smooth. It's a pleasure to fly. DJI knocked this out of the park, guys. Like top to bottom, knocked this drone out of the park. Like when I make these videos, you know, I'm always kind of, I wanna be honest and I wanna tell you guys like, oh, this drone, you know, this isn't the one you wanna buy. Or the Mavic Air 2, I still fly the Mavic Air 2 all the time. Now with the FPV, like this is honestly two of the perfect drones for me, because now with the FPV, I can have those crazy action stops that I've always wanted to get that I couldn't get before with the speed, because the Mavic Air can't go 60 miles an hour. You know, it can't maneuver like the FPV drone. And then I can also switch back to the Mavic Air 2 when I'm just looking for those nice cruisy shots. But then when I want the action, it's back to the FPVs. And like I said earlier, if you haven't already went to dronenerds.com and bought a FPV drone, I'd be really surprised. The Mavic Air 2 was cool, but you know, there was already the Mavic 2, there was options. Like you could survive without having a Mavic Air 2, but can you survive not owning a FPV drone? I could spend all day talking about it, or you could just watch the video and see first person. You could basically see like, wow, yeah, the drone's sweet. It's bass, I like it, it flies. Shoots 4K video at 60 frames per second, which is amazing to think about for this type of drone to shoot 4K video with that quality. I mean, the quality's on point, and I filmed everything in Cine, in D-Cine or Cine Raw or whatever you call it in the app. You can adjust it all right there in the headset. So, you know, for example, when you're flying, you've got the headset, you've got all your features in the headset to go through and check out the different camera features, stuff like that. And then you're flying with the remote like this. So obviously there's no phone here, because when you're flying with the goggles, you're not gonna be looking around for the phone. It's very easy, very simple. You got all the features, you got the brake button, you got everything right there on the controller. I like it, I'm about it. I wanna go out and fly it right now. Actually, it's raining and I've gotta get this video done. But in general, the DJI FPV drone, it's a home run. That's really all I can say. It's a home run. I'll be making more videos kind of talking about some features and stuff like that soon. But I really just wanted to put this out there as like, guys, you know, you're gonna watch a lot of videos here on YouTube, people talking about it, you know, talking about specs and all these things. Or you could just trust me. I've probably had over 100 flights with this FPV drone. I've flown it in front of, you know, 30-foot waves. I've flown it through mountains and almost crashed it a few times. And the FPV drone threw its paces, and well, it's still here. I'm honestly surprised, to be honest. Like, I'm surprised that I didn't lose it, because I did get a little risky getting close to some big waves and things like that when I was in Hawaii, but excited to get back out. I'm actually gonna be driving across America, flying with the FPV drone, different places, and getting some footage for you guys really soon. So make sure, number one, you head on over to dronenerds.com and get the FPV drone right now. Go grab yourself one, and then also hit that subscribe button, because we got a lot more videos coming really soon right here on the channel. There it is, the DJI FPV drone.